of Morning Glory Show. It is a beautiful Monday morning in the city of Belize, and it's the 13th of May already. Can you imagine? We're heading to the midpoint of the year, and so much has happened already. So much is yet to happen. But before we go any further into our show, I want to welcome Maricelli to the show. Good morning, Mar.
Thank you, Marie. Good morning, and welcome to all our faithful listeners.
So how was your weekend?
It was very beautiful. Definitely a lot happening. Mm-hmm. So it was a jam-packed weekend.
Yes, yes. And I know all our mothers were celebrating, and so it's probably a rough Monday morning. It's definitely rough around these parts. But we're here to make sure that your morning is off to a great start. And so we want to thank you for joining us, for tuning in on television, YouTube, radio, wherever you are. We want to enjoy. We want you to enjoy the start of this week. And thank you for giving us the opportunity to enter your space. And so we want to jump right into it, Mar. But before we get started, we want to thank some special people who make this show possible, our sponsors.
Discover the diverse flavors of genuine Costa Rican coffee from Café Brit. We feature all classic favorites and have expanded our collection with new blends. Whether you want to stick to the flavors you're used to or want to explore different tastes, we can assure consistent quality across all our products. With over 35 years of experience, we are confident in our perfected coffee blends. Rest assured that we use the beans from Costa Rica when roasting our signature blends, including dark roast. Enjoy hints of chocolate, dried fruits, and figs in your morning cup with this expertly roasted classic blend. Light roast. Taste a combination of sweetness and nuttiness from apricot, caramel, and malt flavors from our signature light roast. Espresso. Relish in the rich flavors of apple, dark chocolate, and wildflowers with a cup of our favorite espresso house blend. We love creating new blends and discovering new ways to enjoy Costa Rican coffee. Among our new flavors are breakfast blend. Sweeten your morning meal with a mug of our new breakfast blend featuring chocolate and citrus flavors in every serving. Afternoon blend. Enjoy an afternoon cup of coffee alone or with company with this blend, which we specially designed to release a chocolate aroma with hints of peach and vanilla. Fusion. Taste the best of all our signature blends in a single cup with our Fusion coffee, which combines dark roasts, chocolate richness, and light roasts, citrus flavors. Our seasoned coffee roasters have over 3 decades of experience under their belts, mastering the techniques in making the perfect coffee blend. As a staple in the industry, we have access to high-quality Costa Rican coffee beans. Shop today.
Come on!
When hungry or craving, when laughter or tears, enjoy the best snacking or flavors are here. Asadas, bocadas, chiladas, doradas, Belizean fresh snacking done right and done here.
Done right, done here.
Your one-stop marketing shop is Dolphin Productions. Contact us for graphic designing, printing, banners, billboards, t-shirts, embroidery, promotional items, ID cards, and so much more. Give us a call at 223-1837 to get your business marketed. Find us on Facebook and Instagram, or email us at info@dolphinbc.com to get your order in. Dolphin Productions, bringing ideas to life.
And we're back. Thank you for that break. And we want to always say thanks to our sponsors. It's been quite a warm season that we've been in, Mar. Every day, we have to make sure that the fans are directly on us. And I know everybody's contemplating air conditioning for the homes as we head into the summer. And so we know it's going to be a warm day today. And the current temperature is already 85 degrees Fahrenheit. So make sure that you try to stay cool and drink lots of water. Today's winds is, of course, blowing southeast at 7 knots. The pressure is 1008.8. Humidity is 86%. Maximum temperatures actually for today is around where we are right now. So the sun will come up, but it's not going to get much hotter than it is right now. The minimum temperature is only going to be 1 degree lower. So it's going to be hot all day. It's going to be 84 degrees. So this is it. This is it for the entire day. And so we can look forward to mostly sunny, hazy, and warm today. Hot over the inland areas. Tonight's skies will be partly cloudy. Rainfall, if any, will be little to none. Sunrise today was at 5:21 a.m. and the sun will set at 6:15 p.m. this evening. We look forward to a beautiful but warm day in the tropics.
Definitely. And so we can now start with our Holy Spirit prayer. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. My adorable and loving Holy Spirit, promise of the eternal Father, our advocate, I glorify, praise you for being my faithful friend and companion. I thank you for the favors you do, for waking me up daily. Lead me and bless me with your seven gifts. Amen.
Now that we've welcomed the Holy Spirit, we want to get into the most important part of our morning, where we gaze at Him, at His Word, for His guidance as we start a brand new week. And so we get into our reflections and readings for this morning, which is taken from John 16:29-23. Alleluia, alleluia. If then you were raised with Christ, seek what is above, where Christ is seated at the right hand of God. Alleluia, alleluia.
The disciples said to Jesus, now you are talking plainly and not in any figure of speech. Now we realize that you know everything and that you do not need to have anyone question you. Because of this, we believe that you came from God. Jesus answered them, do you believe now? Behold, the hour is coming and has arrived, when each of you will be scattered to his own home, and you will leave me alone. But I am not alone, because the Father is with me. I have told you this so that you might have peace in me. In the world you will have trouble, but take courage. I have conquered the world.
This is the gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ. And I could just keep on reading that last line that really spoke to me. In the world you will have trouble, but take courage. I have conquered the world.
Amen.
And what we all seek is peace. I have told you this so that you might have peace in me. Mm-hmm. You know, the reflection I read this morning spoke about that line. And that's what we all want. We all want that eternal peace, mm-hmm. no matter what. And I think it was you who said to me that, you know, a hurricane could be happening around you, but once you're in the eye of the storm and focus on Jesus, you're going to get through it.
Amen. You know, this is why we have to look at Him in the morning. This is an intentional decision to lift our eyes to the heavens. You know, sometimes when you fall asleep at night, you're thinking about that thing that's on your mind, on your heart. And when you wake up in the morning, sometimes you're tempted to go to that same place. But the word says that new mercies come every day. And this is why, as a part of the show this morning, just in case, you know, sometimes people get up and they don't have time to sit down and read the word. But you can turn on your TV, you can switch to Guadalupe Media, and you can listen to the word. You can listen to some encouragement so that your mind is cleared of all the clutter. It's a new day, and so we want to enter it with the newness that this gift offers. It's a new opportunity for forgiveness. It's a new opportunity for smiles. It's a new opportunity for coming into that office. Maybe you were going in there with your face all along, but this morning, it's a new week, and the newness of this week comes with new opportunities to be a blessing, to be a friend, to forgive.
And a smile goes a long way, you know, and it takes nothing. Yes. But for some people, it's hard.
Yes.
But it, you know, people, there are people who are naturally just very bubbly and friendly.
Mm-hmm.
And it goes a long way, like smiling with a stranger, I tell my students. And for young people, that's, you know, it's almost absurd. Like,
yes,
smile with a stranger.
Or smile when you have a problem, or smile when you don't know how you're going to meet your bills. But that is what, that is exactly what the reading is exhorting us to do. Like, to smile even when it's hard. In fact, that is when we have to press through. That is when we have to really dig deep to find His peace. But it's there. And so, you know, I was thinking lately a lot about when Peter walked on water and he went out to meet Jesus. The thing that made it possible was that he kept his eyes on Him. He did not look at his problems. He did not look to the left nor to the right. He just kept his eyes focused. And you know, yesterday we celebrated Mother's Day. And that is such a daunting task, to be a mother and to point your children to Jesus. Here at Guadalupe Media, Our Lady of Guadalupe is our patron saint. And our motto is, lead us to Jesus. You know, it's so important as mothers that we lead our children to Jesus, because we know this word promised us that there will be tribulation, not only for us, but for the next generation too that's coming. And we have to give them something that will help them, something that will be their anchor, something that will keep them steady. And the answer is Jesus. You know, when I read this, I wanted to know the context when I read this reading this morning. But Jesus was getting ready to leave, you know. He knew that his hour had come. His greatest tribulation had come. And that was the moment when he said, you know what? I need to talk to my friends. I need to tell them and prepare them for what is to come. And so he sat them down and he said, listen, this is because he's about to get crucified, you know, and they're going to see him mocked. They're going to see him stoned. They're going to see their friend who is the king. He came as the king of the Jews, and they're going to see him in his lowest place. And he's telling them in that moment, I want you to have peace. He's preparing them without telling them everything that's to come. He's telling them, when you see what is going to happen, I want you to have faith. I want you to still believe that on the other side there's going to be victory. And that is our posture as believers, Mar, that no matter what we face, we know where our hope comes from. We know that we're going to come through on the other side.
And it's beautiful that this reading is still relevant today.
Yes.
Especially in our society and with all that has happened and, you know, everything everyone goes through. And we can still find that peace in Jesus,
yes,
even today.
Mm-hmm. It's always present. And so he sent a helper, his Holy Spirit. And so he left, and he said at the time, just above this reading, that, you know, you're not going to be alone. You're not going to be alone. And we are not alone. We're not alone. We have been baptized and graced with his Holy Spirit. So we have that same faith that he gave to his disciples. We have that. And so we can walk through the tribulations with our heads up, without looking sad and gloomy, you know. We are his light, and so we have to continue to shine despite what we face.
Definitely, and that's when, you know, you have that peace, mm-hmm. that you're going through something, but you still have that peace. Even if it's grief, no matter what's happening, mm-hmm. you have that eternal peace within you. And then you can be that beacon for others, because they're going to be like, Marie, why are you happy? Why are you smiling? You know?
Yeah. It's been a rough few days in the past, and I'm always conscious of that, you know what? This too shall pass. Whatever you face, it's going to pass. It's not going to last, you know? Ecclesiastes promises us that everything has a season, and so even the darkness, even the situations that we face that are hard, it does pass. And so this is going to pass. Whatever you're facing today, whatever trials may be coming your way, it's going to pass.
And just put it in God's hand, you know, lay it at his feet and mm-hmm. just cry out to the Lord.
Yes. So a beautiful reading to strengthen us as we begin this week, Mara. And so we want to take a break right now, and we'll come back with our saint of the day. And our saint of the day is
Our Lady of Fatima.
So stay tuned.
There's nothing worth more that could ever come close. Nothing can compare. You're our living hope. Your presence, Lord, I've tasted and seen of the sweetest of love, where my heart becomes free and my shame is undone. Your presence, Lord. Holy Spirit, you are welcome here. Come flood the atmosphere. Your glory, God, is what our hearts long for, to be overcome by your presence, Lord. Your presence, to be overcome by your presence, Lord. Your presence, Lord.
Welcome back. The time is 7:21. And our saint of the day is Our Lady of Fatima. On May 13, 1917, in the village of Fatima, Portugal, The Blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, appeared to three young peasant children, Francisca and Jacinta Marta, and Lucia dos Santos, ages 10, 9, and 7. They were tending their family's sheep when a lady, all in white, more brilliant than the sun, indescribably beautiful, standing above a bush, appeared. From May through October 1917, the lady appeared and spoke to the children on the 13th day of each month. News of these apparitions began spreading in the region. The children recalled the Virgin told them God had sent her with a message for everyone in the 20th century. She promised God would grant peace to the world if her requests for prayer, reparation, and consecration were heard and obeyed. Many believed the children's, though many others scrutinized it. When it became known, the lady would visit the children for the last time on October 13, 1917, and had promised a sign to convince the world she had appeared. Many pilgrims made plans to attend. Though the region was subjected to 3 days of torrential downpour, nearly 70,000 people, believers and unbelievers, journeyed amidst heavy rain and mud to witness the predicted miracle. Suddenly, the clouds separated, and the sun appeared between them in the clear blue, like a disk of white fire. The people could look at the sun without blinking, and while they gazed upward, the huge ball began to dance. The huge fireball whirled rapidly with dizzy and sickening speed, flinging out all sorts of brilliant colors and that reflected on the faces of the crowds. The fiery ball continued to gyrate in this manner 3 times, then seemed to tremble and shudder and plunge in a mighty zigzag course towards the earth. The crowd was terrified, fearing the world was ending. However, the sun reversed and retraced its zigzagging course, returned to its position. All of this happened in around 10 minutes. Upon realizing they were safe, the crowd began ecstatically, laughing, crying, shouting, and weeping. Many discovered their previously drenched clothing to be perfectly dry. After what has become to be known as the miracle of the sun, the children were heavily questioned about what they had seen and were told, which remained consistent. The heart of Our Lady's message to the world is contained in what is known as the secret, which she confided to the children in July 1917. The first secret was a vision of hell and the suffering of sinners. The second, a prediction of the end of the Great War and the beginning of another, foretelling World War I and World War II. And the third, a vision of the death of the Pope and other religious figures, foretelling the famous assassination attempt on Pope St. John Paul II on the 13th of May, 1981. The Feast of Our Lady of Fatima was approved by the local bishop in 1930. It was added to the church's worldwide calendar in 2002.
Wow, one of the most famous apparitions. Yeah, with so many promises. Many people have paid keen attention to the words that the young men shared. And that has been one of the main focuses of Our Lady in terms of that apparition. She spoke of hell, which is our motivation to help our children towards believing. She appeared, and she always appears to guide us on the right path, to help us, just like a mother, a wonderful mother, to make sure that we do not make mistakes. One of the things, Mar, is that you actually made a pilgrimage and actually went to the place. You want to tell us about that?
Yes. So I didn't know about it until I saw the movie. And then when I realized, like, wow, I'm going to Fatima. You always hear about Fatima. And it was just an incredible experience. So I did a lot of research about it before I went there. Mm-hmm. And then it reminds me of the reading, peace. Because the peace that you experienced being there, you know, exactly where that the person, where the visions were. And I always think about the three children, you know, age 10, 9, and 7, and why Our Lady would appear to them. So it was such a beautiful experience. And an amazing thing about it is that Father Scott went with me on the pilgrimage, and we have him on the show this morning.
Yeah, he's just joining, dropping in to give us a visit.
Hi, everyone.
So yes, Father Scott, we were talking about Our Lady of Fatima, the saint of today, and I was just telling them the experience of being there.
That is an incredibly beautiful place. You may not know this, like at the end of World Youth Day, I stayed an extra week after. So a convent took me in, and as priests, we try to get away for at least a year for an annual retreat. So it can be 5 to 9 days. Sometimes it would take a 30-day retreat at different times. And so this opportunity, being out in Portugal, where the whole church was gathered, right, under this the Holy Father there. So it's a beautiful experience of the whole church. Then you come to this very holy place. For over 100 years, pilgrims have been coming from all over. And the fruits of that event, which changed the world, just is, you don't like to say you feel it, but it's real. It's just it's just happening. Because at the time point in history, people don't recognize the moment that was happening in the last century, especially with communism coming in. And the World War I was going on at the time. It was such a time of violence or uncertainty in the world. The Pope at the time prayed a novena for peace for the world. And it was in that novena that the Angel of Peace first appeared in Fatima. It started. And so you see this connection, how the movement of the prayers of the church to this private revelation, how God moves back to the church, very often is happening, the way God works in His providence. And so Our Lady of Fatima, just being there every day to be able to, I got to celebrate Mass on the place where Our Lady appeared in the Cova, you know. And it's just a special place to be part of that history, part of that event where heaven and earth touched, right? And these children saw it. Of course, the beautiful message of praying the rosary, right? In a magnificent way, the power of the daily, they pray daily, you know. And it's something that every generation must take up anew, especially now. You see the unsettlements in the Ukraine and the Holy Land, and I think there's a lot of people, even on our streets in Belize, and sadly, right? I think it's unnerving many people. And so we recognize that message in Fatima, Cardinal Ratzinger, when he was writing about the different prophetic visions and the events that came out of that, he said that the message of Fatima isn't done. Mm-hmm. It's like a prophetic sign. Yeah. That continues in each generation to be played out. So that praying the rosary for peace is a very current message for us right now. per se, for certain.
It's almost like that apparition prepared us for what was to come this century, one of the darkest times in the entire history of humanity. And so we were just saying, like a good mother, you know, she pointed us and, you know, was like a forewarning. Even the reading this morning was saying you'll have tribulation, but in that you'll have peace.
Yeah, yeah, she's like a mother. That's right, just coming off Mother's Day. Mm-hmm. Very fitting, isn't it?
Yeah.
I think we need, I like to say, I went home to see my mom, and I haven't seen her for a long time. I came up with a conviction that world peace can be brought through hugging moms.
I noticed that was your message indeed for last week. Mom got a lot of hugs.
Yeah. Hugs. More hugs to moms. I think that would help a lot.
Right,
definitely.
Right.
Yeah, definitely. Yes.
But do you have any special thoughts, Father, on today's reading? I know you weren't here for the first part of our discussion, but we just wanted to bring you into that because it's so hard, you know, even for us, when you're facing situations that here it is that we're being told, you know, we can still have peace. And so many people are searching, we're searching, people are trying to find peace in other ways.
Right.
Because it is the thing, especially for our young, you know, who are so troubled, they are being attacked from every different direction. And so what do you have to say to our...
Throughout the beginning of history, the question of evil has always been a shake of, if God is so good, why does this evil happen? And I think it goes back to the question. Our response is to point to Jesus on the cross, the greatest evil, mm-hmm. where the greatest good came from.
Right.
And so we as people of faith, we want to realize that peace isn't escaping, like I'm going to some island, as much as that may be nice. You know, I'm just kind of getting away from, if I get away from you, then I'll be at peace. And sometimes
right.
if you like that, like you have a temperament, if I get away from you, then I'll be at peace. And we don't believe that. Like, we believe that we can maintain peace in the midst of the storm. There's one priest that would say, you have to find the eye of the hurricane.
Mm-hmm.
You know, and that eye of the hurricane is the Immaculate Heart of Mary.
Right.
You know, and so in the midst of that, that prophetic voice, like soothing voice. I remember when I was a priest in Colorado, we were driving to morning mass, Saturday morning mass, and four of us in the car, and the driver faded right and went out of control. And he started skidding out of control. In the midst of entering to a major car accident, as it turned out, we crossed the highway, rolled the car, slid the car. Two guys were air. Like I remember everyone was knocked out.
Oh, wow.
I stood up. I was able to have my oils with me. I gave last rites to these religious brothers of mine. I was just a first-year priest.
In that moment, yes.
In that moment. But through the whole, even in the midst of the car crash, Jesus, Mary, and Joseph, there was just a peace.
Mm-hmm.
And we have to be able, as people of faith, we have to be able to see beyond the circumstances in a beautiful way. And so Our Lady of Fatima, it was that calming voice in the midst of great turmoil in history.
Mm-hmm.
And so now as this, it begins to rise up again, the prophetic voice of the church is speaking.
Mm-hmm.
And we have to be able to recognize it. Just yesterday we celebrated the Ascension, where the Lord goes away. He's like, wait a second, what are you leaving me for? It's like sometimes our Mother Mercy Montessori children, when they first come to space, they just start crying when mom leaves, right? Ah, come back, right? And so that you could think the church is thinking that, looking up, like, where are you going? Why are you leaving us like this? But he's shifting a new dimension. He didn't leave us. When he came to the earth, he didn't leave the Father. When he left us, he didn't leave us. It's now we can encounter him a new way. I guess the disciples of Emmaus, right? They saw Jesus, and then breaking the bread, they recognized him. And then what happened? He vanished from their sight, but didn't leave him, right? And so that we need these new eyes to find the presence of Jesus at different times. And so the Ascension, they had this bold proclamation, and the church is saying that this year, 2024, is a year of prayer. And then from the year of prayer, 2025 is leading to a year of grace and hope. Grace and hope in the Jubilee year. And this is a beautiful way, you know, the year of grace and hope. And so this is a time, actually, of great anticipation, even though as things unsettled at different places. It's the opportunity is magnificent. Just we had the art underneath the stars the other day, too. So we had the prophetic voice, and the theme was to foster peace through beauty.
Mm-hmm.
We saw this restlessness that's happening, right, in the streets, in our homes. And there's something about art, right, that pushes against the logic of violence and discrimination
right.
and inequality. It's something about art that makes us more human, that brings different people together. And it's a hangout, right? Mm-hmm. It's the one big hangout of a community. And so this happens, that happens.
I was saying, what a gift it is that our community can actually have a concert. And so it's like so many different things happening. And you would think that there's so much darkness. And then in the midst of all that, there's this beautiful concert under the stars. And everything was perfect. You know, I was concerned because we were having like roving blackouts the week before. And, you know, the weather can affect it because it's open air. And then you have this beautiful night just take place.
When do the stars shine the brightest? When it's most dark.
Yes.
Right? And so I think that very thing, you go to Pine Ridge and just, right. And so likewise, when do the stars, the saints, the holy ones of God, shine the brightest? It's in times of adversity.
Amen.
And so we really need to be a people of hope. Mm-hmm. And they see people see the problems. You see people talking and trying to solve this. Everything they can do to solve it without making reference to Jesus or God. And they talk about this, talk about that. And it's just a failed recipe that's been tried and failed, tried and failed. And so our hope, we have our part to play. We each one of us, from the government to the families to mothers to children, different roles that we have to play using our sharing of gifts. But without God, nothing is possible.
Amen.
We can't do nothing. But with God, all things are possible.
Amen.
And so that the fact that the church is calling on this Jubilee year that's coming up, you know, and then the fact that, here we are on our Mother's Feast Day, it's a great time to remember that the invitation to go to her Immaculate Heart,
mm-hmm.
Especially with the prayer and the rosary. It's a great time to be Catholic.
Amen.
Yeah.
And I want to thank you for joining us on Mondays. This is a new, brand new addition to our Monday morning show, so you'll be here with us on Mondays.
Well, I can crash once in a while. Yeah, that's every now and then.
Yeah, right. We love the crashing, and so stay tuned. When we come back, we will be looking at what's happening in the churches and entering our prayerful part of the show, so stay tuned.
The AIC mobile app has been helping many to save time while getting more done, all from the comfort of their homes. When you download our mobile app, our services are at your fingertips. Log in using biometrics, view motor and property policies, file a claim and submit claim photos, request a quote, receive renewal reminders starting 6 weeks prior to renewal, submit renewal request, view branch locations and obtain Google Map directions, make payments via Atlantic Bank Bill Pay, and even contact your customer care rep directly. Prospective clients will have limited access, but can request a quote, place a call to a branch, view branch locations and obtain Google Map directions, file a claim. And since all paperwork is completed beforehand, there's no waiting in line. With all the time you can save, can you afford not to use our app? Download today on the App Store or Play Store, the AIC mobile app. Insurance at your fingertips.
Imagine waking up to breathtaking views of the Caribbean Sea every day. Introducing a stunning home that offers just that, with panoramic ocean views from every balcony. Having 11,000 square feet and being a corner lot, the value of just the land is at the base price of $400,000. Step into a world of elegance and space as you explore the meticulously designed interiors. This home is truly an investment in luxury living. But it's not just about the house, it's about the lifestyle. Don't miss out on this extraordinary opportunity. Call Martin's Real Estate today at 501-615-5886 to schedule your exclusive viewing. No commitment required. Visit martinsrealestatebelize.com for more details and to explore this home and many others. Your dream home awaits you.
Babe, I'm going out to pay the water bill.
You don't need to go out. You could pay it from your phone. Look.
Babe, the credit card bill. I'll go pay it.
You can also pay it with your phone.
Babe?
Yes, love?
I need to go deposit the babysitter's pay.
You really want to go out, don't you? It's okay. I will make the transfer and you go play ball.
With Atlantic Bank Mobile, your personal banking experience is easier and more convenient. Bank your way with any of our digital channels and save time for what matters most.
Atlantic Bank, building the future together.
Come on!
When hungry or craving, when laughter or tears, enjoy the best snacking, our flavors are here. Asadas, mojadas, chiladas, doradas, the least here for snacking, done right and done here.
Done right, done here.
Welcome back. The time is 7:42. And so we're going to start with what's happening in our churches. So this weekend, May 18th, that is this upcoming Saturday, we have the Lay Ministers Convention at Sacred Heart College in San Ignacio Cayo. The theme, Filled and Sent by the Holy Spirit. The guest speaker is Deacon Lawrence Mangar. We also have Our Lady of Guadalupe Mercy Center presents Love and Respect. The love she most desires, the respect he desperately needs. The facilitators are the Marriage and Family Life team, June 1st from 8 a.m. to 5 p.m. And this will be at Our Lady of Guadalupe Conference Room, $80 per couple, food and snacks included. So to register, contact us at 223-2275. Or 610-1254. You can also email at guadalupemercycenter@outlook.com. There is also the Guadalupe procession. Do you want to talk about that, Father?
Sure. It's first time the Guadalupe procession committee decided to begin in St. Martin's. And so the first time in its history they'll be walking through the St. Martin's area, all the way up to Gungulu, Holy Emmanuel, across the bridge, and the host church this year will be Divine Mercy Church, and so it happens to be a time of the Feast of Pentecost as well. So it's a great, going to be a wonderful experience of the church, and so we decided to give some. We have up to 300 tamales we're going to share. See, it depends how many people come. So people can at least go home fed after the procession. We have mass, of course, after the procession. But then the Caris group, comprising of the French, the Spanish and English charismatic groups in the diocese, Send Me and Disciples of the Holy Spirit. It's kind of a united group that Father Jordan encouraged under Caris, and they will be gathering for a Pentecost experience, and baptism of the Holy Spirit, praise and worship. So that would be also a kind of it's the Holy Spirit that renews us, so there'll be opportunity for persons to have that encounter with the Holy Spirit as well. So that, we're looking forward to that.
So that's our Guadalupe of Our Lady of Guadalupe procession, the 19th of May, and it starts at 5:30.
It's actually 5 p.m.
5 p.m.
Yeah.
Okay. And that's at St. Martin's.
Yep.
So there is also a food fest at Holy Redeemer Cathedral on June 22nd, and it starts at 10 a.m. in the school courtyard. And they have a lot of things on the food menu. Turkey dinner, chamole, fried tacos, escabeche, pibil tacos, ceviche, tamales, pastries, soft drink, and more. So June 22nd in the school courtyard at Holy Redeemer Cathedral. There is the youth group at Our Lady of the Way Catholic Church. So they're calling youths aged 13 to 29. 13 to 19 are the junior youths, and 20 to 29 are the senior youths from villages of Vista del Mar, Ladyville, Lord's Bank, Los Lagos, Sand Hill, Maxboro, and Mascal. So if you're interested, you can contact Father Vincent Salam, 622-0999, Miss Chelsea Galvez, 633-6801, or Hayden Jones, 631-5777. There is a vacancy. A secretary is needed at St. Ignatius Church. So the candidate should be bilingual, computer literate, and have good command of the English language. You can send your resume along with two recent recommendations to St. Ignatius Parish at sjv@gmail.com or mmarsden@btl.net. You can also WhatsApp to 610-5544. And the deadline for that is May 25th. And so now we can go into our prayer. So we're going to start with the prayer for a new bishop, Diocese of Belize and Belmopan. Heavenly Father, we ask your blessing once again as we implore your assistance for the Diocese of Belize and Belmopan. We give thanks for your divine providence and the provision of our diocesan administrator and his collaborators who have been faithfully pastoring our diocese. Grant now, we pray, that a holy, learned, and wise man can be selected, approved, and appointed to become our next bishop, one after your own heart, who will humbly govern our diocese so as to lead us closer to you. Even now, inspire us, the clergy, religious, and laity of our diocese, to be ready to work generously with our new bishop when he is appointed, so that we might grow together in your love and continue the good work you have begun in us for the building of your kingdom in Belize as in heaven. We ask this through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the Holy Spirit, God, forever and ever. Amen.
Our Lady of Guadalupe, patron of our diocese,
pray for us. So we can do a Our Father, Hail Mary, and then you give us a blessing, Father?
Sure.
Okay. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. Amen. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread. Forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. Amen.
Hail Mary,
full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou among women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus. Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for us sinners, now and at the hour of our death. Amen.
As the whole church gathers in the centicle, gathers with Mary in the early church, as we wait for the coming of the Holy Spirit in this novena, as we prepare for the power of the Holy Spirit to come upon us, and may God bless you and your communities. In the name of the Father, and the Son, and the Holy Spirit. Amen.
Amen. Have a wonderful Monday. And thank you again for joining us. And thank you, Father Scott.
Sure. Good to be here.
Surrounded by the love from which we came, in this legacy of love,
in the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. Amen.
Dear Heavenly Father, help us to appreciate the qualities we find in each other. Help us to value the everyday things that we might otherwise overlook.
Thank you for creating us in each other our own unique way. Equip us to use the gifts you have given us, and lead us to ways we can sharpen them, both within ourselves and each other.
Your word tells us how we were created with intent and how we're fearfully and wonderfully made. Help us to appreciate these gifts that you have knit into our souls. Amen. A reading from Psalm 139, verse 14 to 16. I will praise thee, for I am fearful and wonderfully made. Marvelous are thy works, and that my soul know it right well. My substance was not hid from thee, when I was made in secret and curiously wrought in the lowest parts of the earth. Thine eyes did see me, my substance, yet being unperfect, and in thy book all my members were written, which in continuance were fashioned, when as yet there was none of them. Glory be to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit, as it was in the beginning, is now, and ever shall be, world without end. Amen.
In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. Amen. Most Holy Trinity, Father, Son, and Holy Spirit, we thank you for this time of entering into morning glory, and to remember that our whole life is a gift of your love. May we give you praise and glory every moment of our day. May the things that we've viewed and the things that we've learned and the things that we've heard resonate in our hearts and radiate to the lives of all we encounter today. We thank you, Father, Jesus, and the Holy Spirit, for loving us into creation, into existence. We thank you for loving us and thinking of us at all times. May the whole world know your love and embrace your love and enter into your love and give you glory from the first moment of the morning to the last moment of the evening and even during our sleep. Everything is a gift from you, Father, Son, and Holy Spirit. Our viewers, our listeners, our supporters, our benefactors, our sponsors, our hosts, the staff, those who've heard this show, may they all be blessed and grow in the knowledge of your greatness, Most Holy Trinity, of your love, Most Holy Trinity, of your power, Most Holy Trinity, of your fidelity, Most Holy Trinity. And may the blessing of the Father and the Son and the Holy Spirit come down upon us in abundance. We call this blessing down through the intercession of the Most Blessed Virgin Mary, who lived every moment of her life giving the Most Holy Trinity glory and winning souls for God. Remember, God loves you, and you're always invited to the Catholic Church. May Almighty God bless you, the Father, and the Son, and the Holy Spirit. Amen. Have a blessed day.
Birds singing, now my alarm's ringing. Get up. Throughout its long-standing history, Atlantida Financial Group has been a symbol of financial strength, growth, and innovation in the region. Atlantida Financial Group is comprised of market leaders such as Atlantic Bank in Belize, Banco Atlantida in Honduras, as well as other companies in insurance, pension fund administration, financial leasing, brokerage services, among other sectors. Its strength and integrity has allowed the group to gain trust from its more than 4 million customers spread over 8 countries and has positioned it as one of the most complete and diverse entities in Latin America. Its leadership and financial strength are demonstrated by key indicators such as assets under management, which as of December 2023 stood at $21 billion and growing. The group boasts the largest pension fund administrator in Central America and the Caribbean. A workforce of more than 6,000 employees strive to serve its customers with excellence and professionalism, pushing the group forward in its mission to continuously provide high-quality financial solutions. Atlantic Bank, as a proud member of the Atlantida Financial Group for 53 years, is committed to this mission, to its depositors, collaborators, and the community that it serves. To this purpose, the bank has built the largest network of branches in the country and remains the only bank in Belize with first-rate international banking correspondence. Atlantida Financial Group, contributing to the economic development of Belize since 1971.
Imagine waking up to breathtaking views of the Caribbean Sea every day. Introducing a stunning home that offers just that, with panoramic ocean views from every balcony. Having 11,000 square feet and being a corner lot, the value of just the land is at the base price of $400,000. Step into a world of elegance and space as you explore the meticulously designed interiors. This home is truly an investment in luxury living. But it's not just about the house, it's about the lifestyle. Don't miss out on this extraordinary opportunity. Call Martin's Real Estate today at 501-615-5886 to schedule your exclusive viewing. No commitment required. Visit martinsrealestatebelize.com for more details and to explore this home and many others. Your dream home awaits you.
Discover the diverse flavors of genuine Costa Rican coffee from Café Rip. We feature all classic favorites and have expanded our collection with new blends. Whether you want to stick to the flavors you're used to or want to explore different tastes, we can assure consistent quality across all our products. With over 35 years of experience, we are confident in our perfected coffee blends. Rest assured that we use the beans from Costa Rica when roasting our signature blends, including dark roast, light roast, espresso. We love creating new blends and discovering new ways to enjoy Costa Rican coffee. Among our new flavors are breakfast blend, afternoon blend, fusion. Our seasoned coffee roasters have over 3 decades of experience under their belts, mastering the techniques in making the perfect coffee blend. Shop today.
Come on!
When hungry or craving, when laughter or tears, enjoy the best snacking, our flavors are here. Asadas, bocadas, chiladas, doradas, Belizean fresh snacking, done right and done here.
Done right, done here.
The AIC mobile app has been helping many to save time while getting more done, all from the comfort of their homes. When you download our mobile app, our services are at your fingertips. Log in using biometrics, view motor and property policies, file a claim and submit claim photos, request a quote, receive renewal reminders starting 6 weeks prior to renewal, submit renewal request, view branch locations and obtain Google Map directions, make payments via Atlantic Bank Bill Pay, and even contact your customer care rep directly. Prospective clients will have limited access, but can request a quote, place a call to a branch, view branch locations and obtain Google Map directions, file a claim. And since all paperwork is completed beforehand, there's no waiting in line. With all the time you can save, can you afford not to use our app? Download today on the App Store or Play Store, the AIC mobile app. Insurance at your fingertips.
Your one-stop marketing shop is Dolphin Productions. Contact us for graphic designing, printing, banners, billboards, t-shirts, embroidery, promotional items, ID cards, and so much more. Give us a call at 223-1837 to get your business marketed. Find us on Facebook and Instagram, or email us at info@dolphinbz.com to get your order in. Dolphin Productions, bringing ideas to life.